It's like a sculpted piece of art. Let me tell you, it's impressive.
Hi, I'm Joe, and welcome to Motor City Boat Works. Let's get to work.
It's now deep into the winter months. It's a new year, and it's bitterly cold outside. Today, I thought I would start working on probably one of the most important parts of the electrical system for the Albin 27 pocket trawler. This is going to be the shore power system. Now, I talked about this before. I had to relocate the shore power connector for the trawler from the port side, bring it over to the starboard side in order to get it closer to where the main panel is going to be and where the batteries and the battery charger and all that are located. Today, I'm going to be messing around installing the shore power connector. This is going to be the plug that I plug into when I'm at a marina. This will give me electricity from the marina, kind of fire up everything inside the boat. We call it a shore power connector.
This episode is all about this piece of equipment. It's called the smart plug.
Now, I have a lot of components going into this boat build. I've talked about it in other episodes. You're going to want to check that out. But I can tell you it's more than $6,000 or $7,000 worth of electrical components alone. So you'll hear me talking about some of these products. I want to bring some of them to your attention. I can't do all of them, and some of them I won't be able to get into a lot of technical information on them or their install. But there are some things that I think are worth talking about. This particular component is one of them. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Motor City Boat Works has no sponsors. I get no compensation for any of the products or the people, the places, the things I talk about on my YouTube channel. I do sometimes put links in case you want to try and buy some of these products, some of the affiliate links where they pay a small commission if you use that link. If you've been watching my channel, you know that I'm a big fan of this particular product. I've talked about it before when I went to the Annapolis Sailboat Show in 2023. The smart plug has been a piece of equipment that I've wanted to put on my boat going back a number of years. I spent more than a year living on my classic 30-foot sailboat back when I was a Marine, and I spent more than 4 years living aboard a houseboat trawler. Anyone who's lived aboard a boat long-term will tell you that there's one thing that's always in the back of your mind. It's something that you're always worried about, and that's fire. Marinas are packed with boats of various ages and quality and levels of maintenance. They're all kind of jammed in there together. I want to tell you, I have some real personal feelings about this. When I lived on my houseboat trawler, one night I was sitting at the table having my dinner. It was dark outside, and all of a sudden it sounded like someone was setting off fireworks, maybe lighting some sparklers. There was a lot of light out the porthole window, and I couldn't figure out what it was. I went outside thinking that it was kids setting off fireworks on the dock, and it turned out that the boat right next to mine was having some sort of electrical incident at the junction box where they plugged in for their shore power. The cable was actually sparking and arcing, and it was the beginning of a fire happening right next to my boat. Now, thankfully, I was able to get their shore power unplugged and get everything kind of turned off. But I gotta tell you, when it happens to you, when you see it firsthand, you begin to wonder, is there something I could be doing to kind of improve my chances, to improve the equipment that has to do with this very important part?
The fact of the matter is, the number one cause of fires on a boat is a shore power failure or some sort of overloaded circuit. When you get right down to it and start looking at the equipment that's used to attach the shore power to a boat, you start to realize how prone to failure some of these components might be, especially if they're older.
On most boats, the shore power connector is just one of these kind of yellow plug-in jobbers. They kind of twist, and that's what locks them in place. You've probably seen them. People get rid of them at yard sales and what have you. These things have a finite lifespan, and frankly, they're not that well built to begin with. It seems crazy to leave the safety of your boat 100% reliant on such a cheap component. For an amateur boat restorer or boat builder, this is where the smart plug enters the conversation. I agree, they're not cheap, but for the peace of mind, it seems like the right component for the job.
I know what you're asking, why spend the money for a smart plug? Basically, the yellow plugs that we're all familiar with, this is old technology. It was designed back in the late 1930s and it hasn't changed in decades. The smart plug makes a number of improvements both on the quality of the components inside the plug and the way it's designed.
In their literature, smart plug has a graphic where they kind of show the difference between the two plugs insofar as kind of their thermal performance. One of the things that you notice is that the smart plug is running a lot cooler. They say this is because of the way the connector is connected inside of the plug are a lot beefier and better than what you'll find in the yellow plugs. If you look at your old yellow plug, one of the things you'll notice is that it's kind of sloppy. There's gaps where the plug plugs into the socket and it's just got kind of a cheesy cover. The smart plug has weathertight seals inside the cover and on the cable. One of the things you'll notice is that the plug fits very snug against the socket. The thing that really makes the difference is that their plug and cable set, well, they lock together. There's a locking mechanism that holds the cable in place. When you use one of the yellow plugs, what you ultimately end up doing is putting it inside the socket and twisting it, all of the support for the cable is reliant upon the metal blades that go inside the socket. The smart plug is different in that the actual housing of the cable is locked in place to the plug socket itself. The smart plug has all the certifications that you're going to need. This product has been reviewed online. There's lots of videos about it. There's lots of write-ups in the sailboat magazines and what have you. Don't take my word for it. Check it out. And let's not forget, this thing is made in the USA. It's not coming out of a factory somewhere in China where you don't know what the quality is going to be like. Smart plug has a bunch of different options. You can get this thing from 16 amps all the way up to 50 amps, depending on your application. They've got plastic ones. They've also got these stainless steel ones. They're used in a marine environment, in RV, and off-grid applications. They've even got smart plugs that are just for data ports. Like say you want to connect a telephone wire or a cable wire, and you want some type of socket for that. They've also got an ELCI breaker and circuit tester. Now we'll talk about this at a later date. This is something I'm considering doing for my boat. It's really a great idea. This is a mandatory safety feature for all new boats and boats that are being refitted with a full electrical system. All right, let's get this thing installed here today. They say that it should take about 30 minutes. All right, so the first thing we gotta do is we've gotta create an opening in the side of the boat where I'm going to mount this shore power connector. I'm going to use approximately the same position, just on the opposite side of the boat from where it originally was. We're on the starboard side here. I'm going to cut a hole inside the upper hull combing here. I'm going to use a 2-inch hole saw. That'll give you my initial opening. In my case, I'm going to start from scratch, so I'm going to start with a smaller hole. I will eventually enlarge it. Now the combing on the side of my boat here, this is all fiberglass, but I'll eventually seal up any coring using some epoxy on the edges. If you're interested, this is what the layup looks like. It's about 10 millimeter thick here at this spot. Once I've got a hole, I'm gonna go ahead and enlarge this thing. And for this job, I'm gonna end up using my favorite tool, the snake. I've talked about this tool before. It's basically a rotary tool with a flex shaft attached to it. Using tiny sanding drums, I'm able to use it to kind of take away a little material at a time. It's really great for getting into tight, small spaces. Once I got the hole where the smart plug's gonna go, now I've gotta get this thing wired up. For the 120 shore power, the wiring to the plug on my boat needs to be 10-3 triplex. It's marine tin wire. The instructions tell you exactly how to hook this thing up.
You need some basic tools to do this. A pair of wire cutters, a screwdriver, utility knife. It comes with the Allen wrench and all the hardware you need.
Basically, you strip off the ends. It goes right into the back of the plug. Ooh, look at that. This thing's all stainless steel. It's really robust. I think this is gonna work here. I measured this earlier. I need about 2.5 inches depth in order to be able to install this thing, and I've got 4 in the spot where I'm gonna be putting it in. There's a protective cover that you gotta kind of snake through first. Once you get everything secured, there's also kind of a locking mechanism that you put on top of the wiring there, kind of holds everything in place. This way, if anybody ever trips over the wire, something gets pulled, well, it's not gonna pull anything out of the back of the plug. Comes with a gasket. It's got adhesive on one side. You kind of glue that to the back of the plug. When you tighten everything down, this will be what makes it waterproof against the hull.
All right.
Now, before I show you the moment of completion, there's a couple of things that you need to know. While I've been collecting a bunch of electrical parts and pieces of the electrical system, I still don't have everything. So even though today I might be able to get the shore power plug installed, I can't actually hook it up to anything because the main power panel hasn't actually arrived. It's being made right now. Very soon, I'll have the main AC and DC panel that's going to go at the helm, and we can really begin to see how things are starting to fit together. I know it's very common on YouTube. A young couple is restoring their old sailboat. They buy a bunch of electrical components, throw it in a pile, and then show you some time lapse while they throw everything together. But that's not reality. The reality is that it takes a lot of effort, a lot of planning and forethought to make sure that everything is going to fit in the spaces that you have available, especially if you're doing some sort of a refit where some of the items are already in place. You need to do mock-ups. There's all sorts of template making that has to be done. We're going to get to that in another episode down the road, and I'll kind of talk about my process of how I go through it. It's just going to take a while. After 10 years, what's the rush? We've talked about this before. There are ABYC requirements about how some of these things are hooked up. ABYC is the American Boating and Yacht Council. This is an organization that publishes guidelines and best practices about how things are supposed to be hooked up and installed on your boat. As much as possible, I'm trying to follow those guidelines. One of the ABYC rules pertains directly to the shore power plug. The rule says that if the plug is further than 10 feet away from the electrical panel, you've got to have its own separate on-off switch. In addition to that rule, there's another one that says all shore power needs to be connected to what's called an ELCI. ELCI stands for Equipment Leakage Circuit Interrupter. It's basically like a GFCI, like you might have in your kitchen or a bathroom. It's a breaker that's designed to trip if there's any sort of leakage in the 120 electrical system. We'll talk about this at a later date, but what you need to know is that it prevents stray electrical current from going into the water and possibly injuring someone who might be swimming near the boat or something like that. Smart Plug makes an ELCI with the circuit breaker tester. This is a piece of equipment that I don't have yet. It's something I'd like to get. I think it would be a very elegant installation and really look sharp. But we'll talk about the main panel, the mock-ups, the ELCI, all these things down the road in another episode. I just wanted you to be aware, there's a lot of things you gotta be thinking about when you're doing this sort of installation.
Look at that, boom!
Whoa, look at that.
I love it.
There you go. I think this thing is looking pretty good. I gotta tell you, this thing is kind of impressive. It's heavy duty. It looks good. It's almost like something that's been sculpted out of stainless steel. I really like it.
There you go. Another project completed in this Pocket Trawler restoration. I don't ask for much. If you enjoyed this channel, hit the like button, leave a comment, and please make sure you subscribe. Thanks for stopping by. I'll see you next time. Stay motivated.